everyone, in this lecture I will be teaching about the Wilkinson catalyst and the properties during the catalysis. Now see, this video will be very short and crisp, and it will cover everything about the Wilkinson catalyst, what are the questions that have been asked in the previous year examination of both GATE as well as CSIR examination. And it is one of the most important topic from the whole organometallic chemistry. So please be careful and watch carefully this video. I will be making some points, so you just have to go through these points, okay? It will be like a summary. I won't be beating around the bush, telling the theories, the whole catalytic loop. I won't do that, okay? Whatever I am telling you, you have to be careful in learning that, okay? All the question will come from that. Now see, the first point is, what is the formula of this Wilkinson catalyst? So catalyst, I am writing, we have rhodium, now Cl, then PPS3, phosphine ligand, 3 units. So this is the formula of the Wilkinson catalyst. Alright, now the question arises, what is the structure of this complex and how many electrons does it have? So see, since here are three ligands and one is Cl, 4 ligands, and rhodium is an element of 5D series, okay? So it will make a square planar complex. Alright, so this is square planar. Now electrons, how many? This is rhodium have 9 electrons, okay, cobalt family. This chlorine has 1, and this PPS3 have phosphine ligand is a 2 electron donor, but we have 3 units here. Alright, so this is 3 to the 6 plus 1 7 and 9, 16 electron. As we generally know that catalysts are usually 16 electron species. So this is 16 electron and square planar. So many a times this question have been asked, so be careful. Now see, the second point is, what is the use of this Wilkinson catalyst? It is used for hydrogenation. Hydrogenation is basically nothing but the addition of hydrogen, okay? It is used for hydrogenation of alkenes, these unsaturated compounds, alkene and alkynes. Alright, let's say I write a basic equation that this is RCH double bond CH2, addition of hydrogen in the presence of Wilkinson catalyst, then we will get RCH2CH3. Alright, addition of hydrogen. Now see, this Wilkinson catalyst, if we look at the ligand, this PPS3. PPH3 is nothing but we have phosphorus and here one phenyl ring, here also, and one here. So if you look at it, it is a very bulky ligand and we have such 3 units. So it will hydrogenate that compound which will be sterically unhindered, because this is very sterically hindered. So it will, let's say we have 2 unsaturated sites, one is saturated and one is least saturated. So it will hydrogenate that site which will be least saturated. Alright, least hindered, sorry. Now this another point is reactivity order. And this question, the question upon reactivity came in GATE 2017. I will discuss after few minutes. Alright. So the reactivity order is basically we have this alkene. Alright. This will be greater than. This is the thing you have to remember, that this compound comes in between this R group on the same side. This will be greater than the cis and it will be greater than the trans. Alright, this is a bond. Alright, and this will be greater than this compound, and the last one is all the R groups. So this is the reactivity order for the Wilkinson catalysis. All right, here we have free ethylene, then this compound, then R group on the same side, then cis, trans, and as you can see, basically here we have the most hindered. All right, and this is most least substituted. All right, this is more substituted and this is least substituted. And you will say that why we can't reduce this one, ethylene, okay, CH2, double bond CH2. Now this act as a catalytic inhibitor. Alright, this act as a catalytic inhibitor. Catalytic inhibitor means it stops the catalysis process, because this ethylene ligand, this molecule ethylene, it attaches to the Wilkinson catalyst, this above catalyst, so strongly that it doesn't come out as a saturated ethane. Alright, so it binds so strongly with the Wilkinson catalyst that it doesn't stick out of the catalyst. That means it acts as a catalytic inhibitor. Alright, so you have to remember it. Now coming to the next point, what is the, when we add hydrogen, alright, then the addition is always cis. Alright, this is the most important point. The addition of hydrogen H2 is cis on the Wilkinson catalyst. Alright, it won't be trans because H2 is a non-polar, and we have studied in the oxidative addition reaction that when we have a non-polar compound, then the addition will be cis. And let's say we have non-polar, let's say we have polar molecule CH3I methyl iodide, we use in Monsanto acetic acid cycle, RHI2CO2, okay, CO2 negative. This is a Monsanto catalyst, and during the addition of this methyl iodide on this catalyst, RHI2CO2 negative, this is a trans because this is a polar molecule. Alright, I hope you have little bit idea about this. So it is always cis, and we know that it is a oxidative addition process, so the oxidation number changes by 2 units. Oxidation number of rhodium atom in the Wilkinson catalyst changes by plus 2 unit. Okay, that means from plus 1 to plus 3. Alright, as we calculated that the, oh sorry, I forgot to tell you that what is the oxidation state of rhodium in this Wilkinson catalyst. So basically this is a neutral ligand, phosphine, we have only charged ligand as a chlorine, so it has a plus 1 oxidation state. Alright, so from plus 1 to we have plus 3. Alright, 1 from chlorine and 2 from this hydrogen. And the next point is, generally the this catalytic loop, this whole process starts with a dissociation of phosphine ligand. Alright, I am writing Wilkinson catalysis initiates by removal of one phosphine ligand. Alright, generally the mechanism is proposed by two paths. One is the normal, first of all oxidative addition, where H2 molecule adds on the Wilkinson catalyst. The another one which is not very popular is the first step will be from the Wilkinson catalyst. Let's say we have this Wilkinson catalyst, square planar. This is PPS3. Alright, this is PPS3, this is PPS3, and this is Cl. So the process starts by the removal of this phosphine ligand minus PPS3. So we are left with rhodium. Alright, this is Cl. Let's say this one cleaves out. This is Cl, this is PPS3, and this is PPS3. So if you look at it, the compound, this becomes like a T-shaped. This is T. Alright. This is T-shaped. This is also a CSIR question. Alright. Now let's jump to some questions regarding this Wilkinson catalyst. So the first question is, as I talked before, that it is based on the rate of the reactivity of Wilkinson catalyst. So as I told you, this is a trans compound, CH3 here and C2H5. This is trans, and in the previous reactivity order, as you can see, this molecule is greater than this trans compound. Alright, so let's say this is 1, this is 2, and this is 3. So this 1 is definitely greater than 2. So in the option, 1 is greater than 3, greater than 2, 1 is greater than 2. Alright, so 2 is greater than 1. This cannot be the answer. Now we are left with A and B. 1 is greater than 3. So first of all, we are sure that 1 is definitely greater than 2. Alright, and since now there is a presence of this methyl group, it makes it more sterically hindered. Alright, so this first will be greater than 2 and then 3. So B is the correct answer. Now come to the next question. Again, the reaction of H2 with Wilkinson catalyst results in, and again there are 4 options. They might confuse you, but I have already told you that the addition is cis addition. So this second option cancels out and this third option cancels out. Cis addition, and the oxidation state changes by minus 2 units, and here we have plus 2 units. So option 4 is correct. Now come here. This came for 4 marks in December 2014. Reductive elimination step in hydrogenation of alkenes by Wilkinson catalyst result in, as I told you, it will be T. First of all, see, Wilkinson catalyst is RHCl PPS3 thrice. Alright, so let's say if one phosphine ligand out of these 3 is leaving out, so it is a neutral ligand, so there shouldn't be any charge on the compound. But here you can see 2 plus, so this cannot be the answer. Plus 1 charge, this cannot be the answer. So one is T-shaped RHPPS3 thrice. Okay, this will be 2 and 1 Cl. Okay, and this is RH hydrogen PPS3 thrice and 2. So in the Wilkinson catalyst we have chlorine as a ligand, not hydrogen. So first is the correct answer. So I hope your doubts regarding the Wilkinson catalyst might have removed. So for the next time, thank you, and please subscribe to my channel, and bye.